Futsal were gathered in Brazil, in Goiânia, for the 15th World University Cup. And 12 teams across four continents, including newcomers New Zealand, who were here for the first time. Their captain, Alex Brody, summed up what it meant.
For everyone in the team, it means a lot. It's the first time a New Zealand team has been to a World Championship. So for all of us to be given the opportunity to do this, it means a lot, yeah. Brazil's the home of futsal, so for us it's an even bigger occasion, and it's such an experience really, to come to a country like Brazil, to not only see the culture but to see the level of futsal. It's just amazing.
Indeed it is. Well, France sent a talented team as well, and they too are honoured to be part of this prestigious event. It's a huge pleasure to come here to Brazil and to represent my country in this futsal mad country. There are some great players. You know, we know people like Neymar, Robinho, who started playing futsal, be going on to play the 11-a-side game. So it makes me really happy to be here, to travel to Brazil and play in such an international event. It's a truly amazing experience for all of us. Well, France and New Zealand share the same accommodation, as do Brazil and China, who are relishing the opportunity of mixing with the hosts and the real super elite. I've got a great feeling being here in Brazil. There's so many good players, and the Brazilians are so friendly. Yeah, we're here, we're mixing together, we chat together. It's just a great time for all of us to be here, mixing with this company. We talk a lot to each other about our different cultures. We try to show them how great our country is. They want to know how things work here, and we explain to them. We don't exchange information about our team, obviously, because we keep focused on our goal, which ultimately is winning this competition. Well, Brazil are the undoubted favourites, and China are taking every opportunity to enhance their status and standing. Well, nowadays, Chinese people, especially the young ones, are more open-minded. We want to know how the world works, how the game works, how everything works around these things. It's a great chance to come here. We've got talented players as well. And it's a big tradition for this sport in China. However, we need to change our culture a bit, I think, so as it gets more knowledgeable about this type of football. Well, for New Zealand's Alex Brody, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and he is taking full advantage of every second that he spends here.
To be in a world championship like this, I think it'll stay in my memory forever. You know, the fact that this is the first time New Zealand has done it, it means a lot, and yeah, it'll stay with me forever for sure.
Well, the European teams, Portugal, Czech Republic, Germany and France, have a lot of ambition as well. The French captain, Sid Bellage, used to play in major competition with the France national team. He acknowledges just how high the quality of this event really is. This is an extremely high level of competition here. It's very close to our national level. If you take a look at some of the biggest teams here and compare to the weakest, there is a big gap. However, there are some great teams. There are those who are beginning to get a better understanding of how the sport plays. There's players here who play with their national teams as well, like me for France, for instance. And the competition between those teams is very high. Well, unfortunately, he won't be in the semi-final for the French team because he picked up two yellow cards. But they are facing a tough ask because France, in their semi, take on these boys, the boys from Brazil. A lot of pressure is on our shoulders. The competition, as we've said, is of a very high level. Representing our country and our clubs as well, we've trained a lot for this University Cup. It's a two-year project which has involved our families around us as well. We're hoping to reach once more a final. We managed to do it in 2014 in Malaga, in Spain. This time, it's important that we follow it up on our home territory and do exactly the same thing yet again. But we will have to be at the top of our game. Not going to be easy for Brazil. Thiago and his teammates have no guarantee of victory, but they have a great fan base here determined to help them repeat what they did in 84 in Sao Paulo when they won this event for the very first time.
2016, university sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.